Vairagya yoga bhakti rasam prayatnairapayayat mam anubhishmandhyam kipam budhiryas paradukhya dukhi tvam sarat sanatanam prabhum asrayami. Vairagya yoga bhakti rasam prayatnairapayayat mam anubhishmandhyam kipam budhiryas paradukhya dukhi tvam sanatanam prabhumasrayami. Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, actually Guru Pad Padma is the transcendental media, or I would say Guru Pad Padma is the transparent media through which you will have to see everything. If you try to see without anugatya, then your darshan can put you into trap, bondage. A pure Vaishnav never try to look anything with enjoying mood. Whatever things happening all around, he can see it is by the desire of Krishna. If somebody tortured me, maybe it is by the desire of Krishna. I will have to learn something. That's why Krishna giving me this kind of punishment. Everything done by Krishna, it is a darshan of a pure Vaishnava. Even one leaf is there in tree, cannot get displaced without the desire of Krishna, directly or indirectly. So Prabhupada giving lesson to us, giving teachings to us, that Guru Pad Padma is a transparent media, transcendental media, through which you will have to learn to see everything. Then you can see as it is what. At present, your ugly darshan can put you in trouble. At present, your ugly darshan can put you in trouble all the time. There is no respite. First of all jivatma, they have some false ego. They cannot prove that they are going to do actual Hari Bhajan. They can try. They can try to prove that we are doing bhajan. But actually, when false ego is there inside my heart, I cannot do bhajan. It is the main thing. False ego, who is having false ego, who is not having false ego? How you can know? I get lesson from my Guru Varga that if you like to become a Vaishnava, then daily we will have to go through the life history of a pure Vaishnava. Don't go through Ujjal Ninmoni at present. It can throw you into the ocean of misery. You can never become a Vaishnava. You will have to follow step. Gradual step. I get lesson from my Guru Bhargo that if you like to become a Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, then daily you will have to go through the life history of a pure Vaishnava. Daily, one or other. You will have to learn something, how they doing bhajan, how they teaching us this way. Now the whole world is going in opposite direction. Many times I told Prabhupada speaking, to arrest the current perverted tide of this fanatic world is a seemingly unpleasant duty of Gaudiya Math. Many times Prabhupada spoke. To arrest the current perverted tide of this fanatic world is a seemingly unpleasant duty of Gaudiya Bhajan. still we will have to follow the track shown by Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Maybe whole world can go against me, I don't bother. Because Prabhupada teaches, Prabhupada speaking, if the whole world going against me, still I am not going to be displaced from the track shown by my Guru Mahatma. If the whole world going against me, if the whole world going against me, still I am going to stand under the umbrella of the lotus feet of Guru, of my Guru Padma, and sing about the same absolute truth. Nobody can change my, because his Vaikuntha darshan. Amendment can be done in this material world. You can pass some rules and regulation in your family. And maybe you are going to change again. And maybe you are the lawmaker, maybe you are the lawbreaker. You are the lawmaker, still you are going to break lawbreaker. There's so many problems there. So any kind of amendment is possible in this material world. But amendment is not possible in that Vaikuntha Jagat, Golok Vrindavan. There you, if you try to apply some amendment procedure, then you are idiot number one. You cannot apply. Whole world going opposite direction. So what to do? You will have to follow the track of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad. Kono ko kamini pratishtha vagini chariya chijari seito Vaishnav. What is the definition of a pure Vaishnav? Very carefully you will have to study the life of a pure Vaishnav. At all if you want to learn, at all if you want to become a pure Vaishnav, if you want to maintain your false ego, that I am superior to everybody, that means you are inferior to everybody. If you want to prove, I know very small girl, 8 years or 10 years, her mother doing all rubbish, loose character, everything. Then each and every time mother speaking, saying, hey, you must do it, you must do it. I am senior to you. Then one day, the small girl speaking, yes, that is the advantage that you are senior to me. That is the advantage you are getting, you are senior to me. But you cannot prove that you are senior to, because your character is loose, everything is loose. How we can prove? So, point is that, if I want to prove that I am superior to everybody, then 100% I am inferior to everybody. Trinadavi slok can be there in book, or I can make a banner in my room, I can. But practically in my life, it is not possible to follow the sloka. Guru Padma used to speak in a joking mood. Many times, Guru Padmadi used to speak in a very joking mood. Baba, Vaishnav havo chilo mane varo shad, trinadobi sunichana suni, pari galo bat. I wanted to become a big Vaishnav, but when I read the slok trinadobi sunit, then I say it is not possible for me to become Vaishnav. Because I can never become humbler than the blade of grass. Guru Padmadhan used to make a joking mood. I wanted to become a pure Vaishnav, nice Vaishnav, but when I come, when I came with this sloka, when I heard that I will have to become Trinadavi, then I said, no, I cannot become. It is not possible for me to become Trinadavi. And without Trinadavi, how and when, where, who done, have done, as doing bhajan or done bhajan, can you see one historical proof? Without being Trinadavi Sunij, who, when, where, done bhajan. You can prove one instant. The first criteria set by Mahaprabhu, if you want to become Vaishnava, then you will have to become Trinada Visunichana Toru Saishana. Amanina Mandana Kitanya Sadahu. I learned from Kesab Goswami Maharaj Guru Vargo. If you want to hate a lady, devotee, then surely you have some weakness. Otherwise, why you are expressing this kind of attitude? If you are going to express some hatred, then be sure you have some weakness. Otherwise, you should be normal. You should not think this is a lady devotee. This conception is not good. If you have weakness, then whole life you cannot cut weakness. If you are not 100% pure for heart. If your heart and mouth parallel, antare vahire samabhavahar amani manodhavo, antare vahire samabhavahar, what is there inside my heart, that is coming out of my speech. I am not a lecturer. I can pass nice lecture in American university, this, that. No. I am not going to collect money, nothing. I have no desire, no expectation from you all. Nothing. No smell of expectation. Only I want to become a pure Vaishnava. That much expectation I have in my heart. And towards that end, I am trying to gather something, kripa, from Guru Varga all the time. Antare bahire samabhavahar. You should not maintain any privacy in your life. You will have to unveil everything in front of Guru Vaishnava. Maharaj, I have some dirtiness, I have some weakness, you see, you clean me. That is different thing. And to cover up dirtiness and to prove that I am big Vaishnava is more offensive. Guru Vaishnava can excuse you. Krishna cannot excuse, but Guru Vaishnava can all the time ready to excuse you. That day I was speaking, Kipa Sindhu Shushang Purno Sarva Sattva Pakara. Last moment of life, last moment when going away from this material world, still Guru Vaishnava bless. You all try to do bhajan nicely. Friend and foe conception cannot be there with pure Guru Vaishnava. Friend and foe conception cannot be there with pure Vaishnava. Guru Vaishnava, be careful about that. What is there inside your heart, that should come out of your mouth. Otherwise, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can arrest you. It is written, Jagadananda Prabhu writing, Gorar ami mukhe boline nahi chale, Gorar achar, Gorar vichar, loile fal phale, Lok dekhano gora bhaja, tilok matto dhori, Goponete ottachar, gora dhori churi. Arrest. You can go through Jagadananda Puni. I can say, I am doing Gaur Bhajan. Gorarami. If you speak, it is not sufficient. If you can accept all the acharana of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu say, here, you are mine. Tava gane gananang videhi. He Radharani, you can count me among your parikari. When that day come, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu say, yes, you are my parshat. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu say. That's why Jagadananda Pandit speaking heavily. If I like to prove that I am doing Krishna Bhajan, you can recognize I am Gauranga Parshat. Huh? I am Goswami. Gaurarami bolile, mukhe bolile nai. If you can accept all the achar acharan of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then automatically Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can approve. Because if Gauranga Parshad, Rup Sanatan, Gopal Bhatto, Raghunath Das Goswami, everybody, Jiva Goswami, if they approve, then automatically Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Prabhupada, if they approve, then if you don't approve me, if the whole world is going to ignore, we don't believe that you are Vaishnava. Still, what it concern to me? If Bhakti Vinod Thakur approve, Prabhupada approve, then yes, more than sufficient. You need not approve that I am Vaishnava. So, Jagadananda Pandit speaking, Lok dekhanu gora bhaja tilak matusuri. I am going to prove that I am doing bhajan and tilak, mala, everything, doing everything, all decoration in my life. All my activities are like decoration. In that case, Mahaprabhu, Jagadananda Pandit speaking, Lok dekhanu gora bhaja tilak matto, ori. Goponete ottachar gorathare chuli. Secretly, I am doing all babichar. I think I can close the room, I can maintain privacy, nobody can see me. How people can know I am not loose character? How people can know? Because room is closed. I can maintain purity, privacy. Not possible. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sitting here. If I want to prove and speak big philosophy in front of you, and if I not going to follow myself, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean Mayadevi can kick me out. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cannot kick. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu kick me, I am going to bolo. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu give order to Mayadevi, kick. So all the time I have to maintain achar-acharan. Main problem is that anywhere in family life, in mathavasi jivan, everywhere, those who are maintaining some rules and regulation, those who are trying to do bhajan, anywhere, maybe you are now in grihastha ashram, but those who are in renounced order, it matters little. Everybody running towards Patishtha, Yashit, like me. Kanaka Kamini Patishtha Bhagini Chariya Chajare Saita Vaishnava. Kanak mean monetary achievement. Kanak Kamini mean you know everything. And Pratishtha Bhagini is the last kick. So if you can go out of these three influence, then you can become Vaishnava. Kanaka Kamini, Pratishtha Bhagini is there. All the time you are trying to get some Pratishtha in family life. You want to get some Pratishtha in Mathavasi Jivan. Pratishtha can kick you out of bhajan. Pratishtha, Yashit, is the last problem in your life. But nobody can go out of that. That is the main problem. Some or other way, these three can come in your life. Some or other way, these three. Kanaka Kamini, Pratishtha Bhagini can come in your life in different form, can come in your life. When Guru Maharaj was there, age was old age, 98, old age, 97, 98, I cannot remember. Many devotees teasing me, you know, always, if teasing, you know, teasing me. You cannot never become Vaishnava. Why? You are never like to go to foreign country here, there, don't like to cook. There you see everybody going to there, doing preaching nicely. I say, I'm not qualified to go for preaching, that's why I'm not. No, you have no interest, we have seen. Because we learned from Prabhupada, Kanaka Kamini Pratishtha Bhagini Shariyajya Shai Vaishnava. At the same Prabhupada speaking, what? Vaishnavi Pratishtha Tate Karo Nishtha Tahana Kurile Rahibero Urab. We learned this thing from Prabhupada. You must express some interest for Vaishnavi Pratishtha. But you are not expressing any interest for Vaishnavi Pratishtha. So you can never become Vaishnava. You can never become successful. And Guru Kripa is there. Though I have no power, Guru Kripa is there, Guru can help me. No! Prabhupada speaking, Vaishnavi Pratishtha Tate Karo Nishtha Tahana Kurile Ravive Raurav. You are less interested about Vaishnavi Pratishtha. And light. I say, how possible? What do you mean by Vaishnavi Pratishtha? Because I am not matured now. I don't understand you. Because by the mercy of Gurudev, I understand something. But what do you mean by Vaishnavi Pratishtha? What do you mean by Vaishnavi Pratishtha? What do you mean by Vaishnavi Pratishtha? They all full gang. They are speaking, Vaishnavi Pratishtha mean, you must go in front, you must preach, you must, because you are less interested to get Pratishtha. So you can never become Vaishnava. I express some doubt. I say I will have to clarify this point to my Guru Maharaj, because Guru Maharaj is alive. I approached Guru Maharaj, paid andavat, nobody was there. Maharaj, I have some question. What question, my son? Baba. Guru Maharaj used to say, Baba. So, but Maharaj, can you take trouble to clarify what is Vaishnavi Pratishtha? So, what do you mean? Mana Vaishnavi Pratishtha, I cannot understand what is Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Can you clarify this point to me? First of all, you try to explain what you understand. After that, I can clarify. I say, by your mercy, I think when one devotee can become pure Vaishnava, I mean, can sit on into the asana of a pure Vaishnava, I mean, chair of Vaishnava Pratishtha. After that, any kind of Pratishtha coming in his life is called Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Guru Maharaj says, yes, right. First of all, you will have to become a pure Vaishnava. After that, any kind of Pratishtha coming in your life cannot put you in trouble. It cannot touch your heart. That is called Vaishnavi Pratishtha. You are right. Then I am getting some sort of consolation because everybody is chiding me. I am junior to them. They are speaking all rubbish against me. I say, Guru Maharaj, clarify this point. If you can become pure Vaishnava, in that case, any kind of Pratishtha coming in your life cannot put you in trouble. That is called Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Because in that case, any Pratishtha coming in your life, you can pass on this Pratishtha to your Gurudev. That Gurudev can pass on this Pratishtha to his Gurudev. This way all Pratishtha can go unto the lotus feet of Nityananda Balaram or Radharani ultimately. That time I was getting some consolation. I am foolish actually. I don't understand. Anyway, from then onward, I was very alert to understand. Because any meaning, you like to get some meaning of Shastra, any meaning, if you like to get out of Shastra, you will have to follow your Guru Vaishnava, Shauta Pantha. Artho karo Vaishnava Anugatte. Any kind of meaning, if you like to make, Siddhanta, you will have to 100% in total, you will have to follow your Guru Vaishnava. Sauta Pantha. Otherwise, any kind of Siddhanta you are speaking, maybe You already memorize, not supporting your character, not supporting, or maybe you are speaking false philosophy or right philosophy. This is the one problem. The sloka I started with is very important. You never try to understand this point. Repeatedly we tell, it's not a matter of joke to start Hari Bhajan. Many times I told, many devotees going against me, they are making plot against me, like to kill me. I am very peaceful, no problem. Follow? What I mean to say? Actually, many times I told that first try to understand Vaishnavi Pratishtha. After that, you can go for preaching, you can do everything. Otherwise, mispreaching can be there. Preaching mean, what do you mean by preaching? What do you mean by preaching, actual preaching? Chaitanya Charitamrita speaking, Krishna Bhakti Bina Nahi Bhakti Pavartan. You cannot install bhakti inside the heart of a bonded soul. If you don't have bhakti, how you can install? You are going for preaching. It is not preaching, it's mispreaching. Maybe you can come to fight with me. You cannot do anything. It is mispreaching, not preaching. Preaching means, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that if a pure Vaishnava not speaking anything to you, his character, activities is more than sufficient to inculcate bhakti inside you. He is not speaking. Ramanujacharya speaking, a pure Vaishnava can speak with you, cannot speak with you, matters little. If you can sit and watch for a small time, it's more than sufficient. It can give you bhakti, bumper success. But we don't know how to do good association, bad association. I cannot say there is no Vaishnava in this world. I am number one to declare that I am not Vaishnava. But for that I cannot speak that nobody is there, Vaishnava. Maybe Vaishnava is there, I cannot identify. Maybe I cannot identify. First of all, Guru Tattva, that day also I was speaking, Aprakita Guru Tattva. Jo Mantra Sa Guru, Jo Guru Sa Harihi. This, you realize this point? Jo Mantra Sa Guru, Mantra given by my Guru Maharaj, is equal to Gurudev. And what is Gurudev? That is Hari. Shakshat Haritana Samasya Sastai Ruktastata Bhavvate Vesadbhi Kintu Pavurjo Priyavatasya Bande Guru Sicharana Arvind. Jamantu Saguru Joguru Saharihi Tasmat Sarva Prajatneno Guru Meva Prasadayat. Meva, affirmative. 100% you will have to satisfy Gurudev Vaishnav. How? Out of your humble attitude, you can satisfy. Today is the disappearance day of Sanatan Goswami Pad. Each and every day, you must grow through the life history of one or other Vaishnav. You have to go through the life history of a Vaishnav daily. Every day, don't forget, if you like to become a Vaishnava. Try to see it in front of all. Put Tulsi in between. And you sit among everybody and try to do Harinam. You do Harinam, put Tulsi, everybody should sit in one place and try to do Harinam loudly. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you go on doing seva in hand. It is the advice, vital advice of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You go on doing seva in hand. Without seva, you cannot prove that any Vaishnava can come out successful. Without seva, you will have to shed sweat all the time. Yes! Every day, to shed sweat. Prabhupada speaking, gallons of blood you will have to shed, but you are not ready to give one drop of blood. So, Sanatan Goswami Pad, today is the disappearance day of Sanatan Goswami Pad. I already told you, jo manto so guru, jo guru so harihi, tasmat sarva prajatne no guru meva prasadaya. Can you realize that your Gurudev is non-different from Gauranga Mahaprabhu? Can you realize? Can you touch Salgram and Giriraj and speak, I can realize? If you can speak, if you can realize this point, that Gurudev is just equal to Krishna. Just equal to Krishna means? Tattva, same. In that case, you can get all the treasure of your bhajan. Nobody can stop you. Nobody can stop you. You can go. Green signal. Prabhupada speaking. The day you can realize this point. Green signal. Yeah. But out of 100%, if not more, 99%, they cannot realize this point. That's why they cannot come out successful in bhajan. Sanatan Goswami Pad, Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad, they all wanted to teach us first the third slok spoken by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But I like to memorize so many philosophy to get clapping in the society, so nice darshan speaking. But I am not ready to follow third slok of Chaitanya. Then the third slok means you are not qualified to do Hari Kirtan. You are not qualified to do Hari Kirtan. If you are not going to follow the third slok, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Tinado Visunichuna Toru Sushna Amanina Madhana Kitanyo Sadaha. Kitanyo. You'll have to sing the glories of Krishna, Harinam. When you can do, provided you are Tinadavi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, whole day and night you will have to do seva in hand. Don't try to lead peaceful life inside room. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you can go on doing seva in hand, all day and night, and cry, and go on to Hare Krishna, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving warning. Then someday, Krishnam can appear inside your tongue. You can go in the Bhajan Kutira Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It is written, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They are putting one banner. Tomra sarvakkhon hate seva kore jabe, ar mukhe harinam kore jabe. Kono na kono din tumader jiu hai Krishnanam udaya hobe. I can do Krishnanam. I am doing 1 lakh harinam. Idiot number one. Krishnanam mean Krishna. Krishna and Krishnanam same. You want to put Krishnanam under your influence, but Krishnanam is never influenced by anybody. Krishnanam is unique. How you can say, I am doing 1 lakh harinam? Huh? I am doing 1 lakh harinam MPFs. Maybe you are not doing even one single harinam. Who can say? Who can say? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when speaking, giving condition, if there is one harinam, in your tongue. Ek Krishnanam jar mukhe. One Harinam appear. Be sure that he is Vaishnava. Mahaprabhu speaking. Sattvaraj Khan coming. In 3 years, gradually Mahaprabhu, first year speaking this condition, second year then, how we can understand who is Vaishnava, second, third year Mahaprabhu speaking, Jahare Dekhile, you can watch a pure Vaishnava, you can go follow a pure Vaishnava, you can go, then you can see in road, so many people, they are not doing bhajan, they are paying dandavat. Yes, that Maharaj going by car, but somebody looking, they are paying dandavat. That means he is pure Vaishnava. Follow what I say. If you look a pure Vaishnava, if you look a pure, provided you are not doing any aparat, pap can be there, countless pap. But if provided you are not doing any aparat, then if you see a pure Vaishnava, you can automatically your head shrugging. Like I told, you know, you had that appearance day of Prabhupada, disappearance day. You can remember. Madan Mohan Malabhya, great gigantic scholar. He is speaking, in my whole life, never my head was down in front of anybody. Only in front of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, whenever I come in front of Prabhupada, I look at him, automatically I don't know. My head become down. Automatically, my head. He is a symptom of pure Vaishnava. You can confess or you cannot confess, that's up to you. But he is Vaishnava. So try to remember over and again this point. Don't try to lead your ideal life. Try to do something for Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. Somebody putting question in front of Prabhupada, Prabhupada, we are laymen, we are not educated, we don't understand. In one word, we like to know one definition about who is Vaishnava. Prabhupada, okay, I am not going to speak any sloka. You can understand Bengali? Yes. Prabhupada speaking, now try to hear. He who is going to do something, always, he, who is always trying to do something for Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan, be sure he is Vaishnava. One sentence, be sure. He who is always trying to do something for Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan, be sure he is Vaishnava. So nice definition. You have to say to your, not money, not only money, your blood, you will have to give whole day and night. You will have to implement the desire of Guru Vaishnava. I will have to implement the desire of Prabhupada and Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, Kesava Maharaj. For that whole world going against me, kicking me, insulting me, still it is, I can give honor. Very good. I never mind. Very good. But my desire should be perfect. There should not be any infiltration. There should not be any infiltration. Any infiltration. Adulteration should not be there. It should be pure. My desire and aim. In small age, in school, there's master, they're giving instruction. Write some pressy on this topic. What is your aim in your life? We are writing, I want to become a doctor, I want to become a philosopher. Eh? You write, small age? Pressy paragraph, the teacher giving instruction. Hey, write your aim in life. Nobody knows. What should be the aim of my life? Eh? Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das. Now actually point is that you will have to shed blood and shed sweat whole day and night. Do something concrete. Then today or tomorrow you can expect Harinam. If you sit, lead your ideal life, you can try to prove that I am doing one lakh Harinam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sitting, even one Harinam you cannot. You have no power to do even one Harinam. Because if you one Harinam appear, then automatically you can become Vaishnava, you can become humbler than the blade of grass. This is the condition you will have to follow. Now, Sanatan Goswami Pad, long time it will take 1 month to discuss all about Sanatan Goswami Pad. But before entering into the topics of Sanatan Goswami Pad, I started with the sloka. You can remember, I started with the sloka. Vairagya yoga bhakti rasam priyat nai rapayayat mam anubhivshamandham. Who writing? Another great Vaishnava. Unparalleled, unbeaten. He is writing this way. Raghunath Das Goswami. He himself great Vaishnava. He is expressing humble attitude. He is crying and speaking. Is only Sanatan Goswami Pad. Vairagya yoga bhakti rasam. Bhakti ras, full of vairagya detachment. Because vairagya, if you like to prove that you have a detachment, maybe it is false. That's why Sarvam Bhattacharya, you can remember, told when in front of Mahaprabhu started doing 100 sloka. Like wind, 100 sloka. Vairagya vidya nija bhakti yoga sikhyartham ekam purusho purano. This sloka. What Sarvam Bhattacharya wanted to mean, that so long, Sarvam Bhattacharya speaking, I was like fox, dry, only ba-ba-ba-ba-ba speaking dry philosophy. Now, by the mercy of Chaitanya Charan, ocean of transcendental rasa. Oh. Sarvam Bhattacharya crying and speaking, 100 sloka, like wind. And Mahaprabhu approved. Sato slok kori more jekoile stavan. You speaking 100 sloka, like wind. 100 sloka, like wind. This sloka, if somebody going to read, surely going to get bhakti and to my lotus feet. It is the approval. Why? Mahaprabhu. Shato slok kori more jekoile stavan. Shato slok kori more jekoile stavan. You are speaking 100 sloka and doing, glorifying me. If somebody have the scope to go through this sloka, it is my commitment, he is going to get prema unto my lotus feet. I published 10 years back in Bengali, Sarvam Bhattacharya sloka, 100 sloka. Now what I mean to say, Sarvam Bhattacharya want to speak, Vairagya Vidya. When Vairagya become Vidya, when your Vairagya can become Avidya. That is the first point. When your Vairagya can become Avidya, when your Vairagya can become Vidya. Don't try to show that I have detachment. On the contrary, I can try to prove that I am a material man. See. Oh. When Vairagya is totally getting backing of Guru Vaishnava, nice, that is called Vairagya Vidya. when not enjoying any backing by Guru Vishnu, then your vairagya is, you can throw. You can throw like garbage. Penniless. Not penniless, useless. Smell, bad smell. You can throw out like garbage. Like stool and urine. Who care, man, you are going to show your vairagya? What value you have? If it is not, if your vairagya is not approved by Gurudev, Vaishnav, what use? Now Raghunath Goswami crying with humble mood. We will have to learn. We will have to learn day and night, go through our life history of Sanatan Rup, Raghunath Goswami, to become a Vaishnav. At all if I like to become a Vaishnav. If acting is my first and foremost thing, then I can prove that I am a Vaishnav. If I like to become a pure Vaishnav, whole day I will have to go and pay dandavat to all Guru Vaishnav and think that I am useless. Prabhupada teaches us, this should be our darshan of a pure Vaishnav, Prabhupada speaking. Whole world doing Krishna bhajan. Only I cannot do Krishna bhajan. Prabhupada teaching us. If you are pure Vaishnav, you should have that kind of feeling. Whole world doing Krishna bhajan, directly or indirectly. But I am not doing Krishna bhajan. Because directly, indirectly, everybody doing Krishna bhajan. Really so. Those who are maya, those who are thief, those who are foolish, those who are dacoit, those who are, you know, pleader, those who are doctor, they are all serving Mayadevi. Mayadevi, na? Those who are teacher also. They are serving Mayadevi. Mayadevi mean? For where from Mayadevi come? Krishna. So directly, indirectly, they are doing Maya Seva. Maya Seva means Krishna Seva doing. Not directly, indirectly. So anyway, you should have that kind of feeling that whole world doing Krishna Bhajan. Only I am the only person who cannot do Krishna bhajan. This kind of feeling, if you have any day in your life, instantly you can feel he is superior to me, he is superior to me, she is superior to me, I am useless. Always. You should have that kind of feeling. Very secretly you try to collect the dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vishnu. When Guru Vishnu going away, then that place we can rub our hand and put. How we can get power? How we can do bhajan? Sanatan Goswami Pad, about Sanatan Goswami Pad, Raghunath Goswami speaking. It is only Sanatan Goswami who wanted to feed me forcefully, nectarian, bhakti rasa, full of detachment. Hey, drink, no, you drink something. You drink, oh, so nice, one small baby. No, I cannot drink. You drink something, you drink, no, I cannot. Mother forcefully, overnight, oh, so nice, give. No, now you cannot. You will have to take medicine after that again. Bhakti, what is bhakti? We have no idea. Follow, never mind. What is bhakti? We have no idea. Bhakti is not a matter which you can find in the material world. Bhakti is only coming from Golok Dham, Vaikuntha Dham. Somebody can speak, bhakti is the matter. Bhakti is not a matter. You can go to market and buy some bhakti, 1 kg bhakti. Not there. Bhakti is there. How we can bhak bhakti? So, Raghunath Das Goswami is saying, Kipam Budhi, here is the ocean of Baira, Kipa. Paradukha Dukhi. It is the symptom of a Vaishnava. It is a symptom of Vaishnava who like to express some gratitude You want to express some humble attitude, want to express some, you know, honor to everybody. Shaisha Vaishnava Dharma Shavare Pranati. It is called Vaishnava Dharma. You have to pay Dandavat. Maybe you can say that he is Acharya, how he can pay Dandavat? We have seen in the life of Guru Maharaj. Any small boy entering room, if getting some sound, Guru Maharaj paying Dandavat. That boy entering the room to pay Dandavat to Srila Bhaktivinoda Puri Goswami Maharaj, but Guru Maharaj getting some sound, somebody entering. Before paying Dandavat, Guru Maharaj paying Dandavat to him. Before. So, we learn how to become Vaishnava, humble. He never insult anybody. Now, Sanatan Goswami Pad, I like to discuss some Siddhanta, because I have no time, limited time. 1 month, fully 1 month period, only about Sanatan Goswami Pad. If I discuss, still I cannot finish. So, I will have to touch some Siddhanta Visha, and humble attitude of Sanatan Goswami. I can touch only this much to learn humble attitude. So Rupa Sanatan, actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when reaching Ramkeligram, before that they used to write letters to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through somebody. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu directly going to Ramkeligram, nobody knows for why Mahaprabhu going wrong direction. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking in front of Rupa Sanatan directly, when night time Sanatan Goswami, Rupa Goswami coming with Anupam, and Jiva Goswami was a small boy, baby, full. Then Mahaprabhu speaking, nobody knows why I am coming here in Ramkeli. Everybody speaking, Prabhu going this, why? I come here to meet you. There's Rupa Sanatan with some trina, you know, grass and teeth. Many times I uttered this sloka. Dante tina kam dhayo. This sloka is known. Padayor nipatyo, kaku shat etada ham babhrimi, babhrimi. He sadhavo, sakalame vabihaya dura, chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam. Leave everything, all useless. You are waiting for honor, somebody can give you honor. You are waiting that you can get some enjoyment in your life. Or you throw, kick everything and try to understand what is bhakti. All problem can be solved. All problem can be solved anywhere in this 14 world. Any problem there can be solved. The day you understand that is bhakti. The day you understand this is bhakti, then all problem can solve. In this 14 world. In this 14 world, all problems solved. Only the day you understand this is bhakti, all problems solved. All false ego, all agony, pain inside heart, somebody insult me, all vanish. The day you understand that it is called bhakti. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving kippa to Rupa Sanatan, and Mahaprabhu requesting Nityananda, all his parshad, you all do kippa to him. Because direct Krishna kippa, direct Chaitanya Mahaprabhu kippa is not possible. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu requesting Nityananda Prabhu and all parshad, you all bless Rupa Sanatan, you bless them. They want to, they are so humble, everybody blessing. After that, very short, I'm only touching. So, then after that, Rupa Goswami Pad is a finance minister. gone with Anupam. With Anupam, that time Jiva Goswami Pad was there at home. With Anupam, Rupa Goswami instantly leave home. When they get information, Prabhu running towards Vrindavan to meet Prabhu, the Rupa Goswami Padana. Sanatan was there, but the king was fed up. Why my chief minister not coming? Somehow he got information that he is sick. Sick? Then I have good doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, I can send. Ayurvedic doctor going there, checking him off. But no disease. His health is very nice. No sugar, no pressure, nothing. Very nice health. Then why not going? Then king himself coming, Hussein Shah. Hey, why you are not going? All my, you know, activities with you. You are my prime minister. I cannot do any service anymore. Why? Eh? Why? Because anymore I cannot do. Then they discover, king discover, that Sanatan Goswami Pad discussing Bhagavatam with 18 or 20 Vaishnavas, Brahman, Pandit. Because in dream, Sanatan Goswami got Bhagavatam. In dream. One day, Sanatan Goswami looking in dream, somebody giving a nice Bhagavatam. And Sanatan Goswami, look, this Bhagavatam is Krishna himself. After that morning time when get up, where is Bhagavatam? False dream came in my life. Then after they took bath, this, that. After that some Brahman came, pure Vaishnava, giving one Bhagavatam, wrapped in a red cloth, cheli. Oh my God, in dream Bhagavatam came. Oh, it's then from then, Sanatan Goswami, 100% sure, that Bhagavatam is Krishna himself. That's why Sanatan Goswami writing one sloka about Bhagavatam. Bandana, glorifying. Sanatan Goswami was in trap, in jail by king. King cannot allow him to go away because his main activities is a prime minister. How king can allow him to go? Hey, I can arrest you. Can stay in jail. Okay, as you like, you can give me punishment, you are king. But I cannot do any seva. I cannot do any service anymore. Then king wanted to put him in jail. After that, first requesting, you can go with me because I am going to Orissa to fight. Sanatan Goswami says, you are going to destroy your Hindu temples, this, that, deity. How can I go to assist you? I cannot go. You can go. Then I can put you in jail. Okay, as you like, put you in jail. Rupa Goswami Pad with Anupam, all huge property, jewel, golden coin, huge amount of property. Putting in boat, in sack, and going, crossing the river, and distributing this property among some of his relatives, among some Brahman Vaishnav, and 1,000, somebody speaking 700, somebody 1,000, this way, golden coin, putting inside a shop, of a grocer shop, you know, grocer shop, chal, atta, while you are going to buy, that man was very friendly. He said, you will have to keep this money for my elder brother, Sanatan. You have to keep this money. As and when required, you will have to give. Huh? Okay? Give the money. After that, Rupa Goswami with Anupam gone. And Sanatan was in jail. And king gone outside for fighting there. In the meantime, those were the, you know, taking care of jail superintendent. Then Sanatan Goswami discussing with him. You see, you are Jinda Peer. You are actually Allah. Huh? So I have done so many seva to you. Now today is the time you will have to repay. Well, how you want to get repay? I have done some seva to you. But today is the time you will have to pay something to me. I am in danger. You have to make me free. No! Oh no! How if I make free, then king can come and cut my throat. No, 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 they cannot know. King cannot know at all. Very secretly. No, I cannot. 500 golden coin. 500, I can live, but king can know and give me punishment. In material world also you can get this kind of provocation, this kind of lucrative offer. Some big officer, he want to prove that I'm honest. Sir, I have some problem. I can pay you 50,000. What do you mean? I want to mean actually I can do some seva to you. Don't speak that way. I can give you 1 lakh for your seva. Don't speak that way. After that, if the amount going up 2 lakhs, well, I can do, but some problem is there. No problem, sir. Nobody can know. This way, you know, you have some standard, na? Of your moral standard. That moral standard can be broken by any lucrative attitude. Ajamil was bound to break his... Ajamil was bound to break his moral character. Because that much power was not there with Ajamil. Ajamil was fine, nice Brahman. Doing worship of Shalgram, everything. What wrong? But not so much kripa, chitbal. So, his moral standard broken into pieces. Eh? You see? So, Sanatan Goswami ultimately, I can give you 700 golden coin. Well, I can make you free, but there's problem actually. Nobody can know. I cannot stay here. I can go to Makkah, Medina. I can go there. I can become Darvish. Darvish means I can do bhajan. I can do bhajan of Allah. I can go to Makkah. Really so? Yes. I cannot say. Nobody can trace me out. So you can say this much. In the morning time, there's the Sanatan Gosai going to a latrine. There was, you know, chain was there. Somehow jump into water, Ganga, and then we cannot trace him. This much we can say, because lock is so much heavy. Well, this way, Sanatan Goswami gone. By the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sanatan gone. Now, Sanatan Goswami gone to Varanasi. I am speaking in short, because I have to speak some Siddhanta. Gone to Varanasi with Darvish. Darvish, you know, those were Muslim sannyasi. And going everywhere, from everywhere they are taking information that Prabhu staying in Chandrasekharacharya Bhavan. Really? Chandrasekharacharya Bhavan. And Tapan Mishra house, Mahaprabhu used to eat. Follow my point. When Tapan Mishra is Vaishnava, but still Mahaprabhu never wanted to break the rules. Mahaprabhu accept Tapan Mishra, who? Tapan Mishra and who? Chandrasekharacharya. Both. But still Mahaprabhu never wanted to break rules and regulations. Sanatan Gosai took information when waiting at gate. If Prabhu Antarjami, Prabhu can call me. In the meantime, Prabhu inside, talking with all devotees and speaking. Mahaprabhu speaking, Chandrasekhar Prabhu, you go outside and one Vaishnava is there in gate, you can bring. Chandrasekhar is going, open the gate. No Vaishnava there. Come back. Prabhu, no Vaishnava is there. No Vaishnava there? Somebody there? Yes, one Darvesh is there. Yes, I mean him. You bring him. One Darvesh is there. You bring him. Then Sanatan Goswami enter with tears rolled down his cheeks and paying prostrate down like mad, crying, and Mahaprabhu running to touch him. Hey, don't touch me, Prabhu. I am actually fallen so. Prabhu speaking. Prabhu speaking. Sanatan, don't speak like that. I am touching you to purify myself. You have that much purity. You have that much purity that you can purify the whole world. What to speak about me? Don't speak like that. Come to me. Embrace. Prabhu and Sanatan both shedding tears. Prabhu allow him to sit near him and, you know, massaging his backside. And hearing, oh, Prabhu knowing everything, antaryami, but still asking, how you get free? This way. Then asking, Chandasagar Prabhu, Chandasagar, you go, you can go to Ganga Ghat, Varanasi Ghat. There you can shave head, everything, and make him Bhadra. Bhadra means Vaishnava Besh. Then all save everything. After that, Chandasagar Acharya wanted to give a new cloth, new piece of cloth. But Sanatan told, I cannot take new cloth. If you at all want to give cloth, then you can give me old cloth, used cloth. That I cannot give you. Yes, I need it. If you can give one old cloth, then I can take. If you give new cloth, I cannot. Well, as you like, give new cloth. Then that new cloth, you know, cut into three pieces. One is Kaupin, one is Vairvas, one is Uttariya. And come in front of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu laughing, now nice looking. Follow. If somebody going to criticize, who give Besha to Sanatan? He is idiot number one. There is spontaneous, naturally they are Paramahansa. Sanatan Goswami cut the one cloth into three pieces and putting Kaupin, but who give it? You should remember, when coming in front of Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu approve it, laughing. Now nice. Mean? Mahaprabhu approved. So his base is approved by Mahaprabhu. Don't speak like that, like madman. You should have bhakti. You should speak with full respect. Don't speak like that. Who give sannyas base to Prabhupada, Vimalapusha Saraswati? Don't speak that way. You can go down hell and hell. Don't speak that way. So Mahaprabhu approved. Now Mahaprabhu joking, Sanatan, where is your boat kambal, that costly kambal? That last day, Sanatan could realize that Mahaprabhu don't like that I use this kambal, it's very costly. Then Sanatan going to, again to Ghat, there he find one Gaudiya Vaishnav, is one cloth, very tight cloth, cloth after cloth, they, you know, stitch, cloth, one cloth after. That is called Katha. Katha. In dictionary, you cannot find Katha. So I am bound to speak this. So there actually, he requesting, I want request to you, I'm going to beg something. What? But you have to take this costly kambal from me and give this Katha. You are joking with me? Huh? This kambal is so costly? No, I'm not joking. I mean it. I'm not joking with you. Then after that, give the kambal, taking the katha. With katha, when coming in front of Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu started laughing. Now, okay, very nice. I was also thinking about that. Krishna is the topmost doctor. And if Krishna giving relief of all disease, why Krishna can keep one disease untreated? I was thinking about that. so costly madhuk, so costly kambal, so costly boat kambal, and we are going to take madhukuri. You have no right to take madhukuri until and unless you are penniless. People think it's a matter of joking. I can go to Braja and beg. Guruma used to say, you will have to pay. If you are going to take one piece of bread from a Bhajavasi, then you will have to pay. If you cannot pray, then you will have to become a dog next life in the courtyard of that Bhajavasi. Don't think it's a matter of, I have some bank balance. Oh, Maharaj, I am big Vaishnav in bank balance. I have 80 lakhs rupees. And now I want to say, I am Niskinchan. Mayadvi can give a big kick on me. Thak! Useless. Go. Garbage. Dirty. In Bhajan field, we are making some garbage, stool and urine. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of Namhatta. Now you follow my point. We are on the one to make garbage in the field of Namhatta. And Guru Vaishnava like to clean. Hey, clean! Unwanted object, stool and urine. Useless. Namhatta should be clean, purified enough so that Nityananda and Gauranga Mahaprabhu can get enough, sufficient satisfaction, full satisfaction, not a matter of joke. I can do bhajan, Maharaj. Okay, you do bhajan. And show how you can do bhajan. So now Sanatan Goswami Pad started taking lesson from Mahaprabhu, full 1 month. Oh, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving lesson to whom? Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami so humble. I should be ashamed of that fact. Then how possible? Sanatan Goswami, Bharadraj Brahman, topmost. If you think about their family heritage, but still they think, don't touch me. We are from low family. We are doing low association of Muslim people. Prabhu, don't. If they are going to show that kind of humble, you can remember when Vallabh Bhatta came to invite Mahaprabhu at home in Arail Gram village, just opposite of, Tribeni. The neighbor. Then Rup Sanatan paying Dandavat. He want to embrace. Then Mahaprabhu was joking with them. Joking with, don't touch them, they are actually from low caste. Prabhu, I think they are from high caste. Because Mahaprabhu knowing has some value. According to Vallabh Bhatta also now giving some value to Varnasam Dharma. So speaking, don't touch them, they are actually low caste. No, Prabhu, I think you are joking. They are from high caste, I think. They are speaking always Harinam. And Rupa Sanatan going back, don't touch us. We actually follow this way. And Rupa Sanatan never wanted to come in front of Jagannath temple. Never want to enter into Jagannath temple. They never. Never. They think we are fallen soul. Many times such thing happen. Whenever Rupa Sanatan going to Purushottam Dham, I am just touching some point. They used to stay with Haridas Thakur in an exclusive place in garden, Aitota. And Sanatan Goswami going, Rupa Goswami, whenever they are going, they are staying with Haridas Thakur. They are not going to take darshan of Jagannath. They say, we have no power, no right. From distance they are paying dandavat to the wheel, chakra. Even they don't like to pass through adjacent area of Jagannath main temple. Why? Mahaprabhu testing. One day Mahaprabhu requesting him to come to me. Then after coming, Mahaprabhu asked, Mahaprabhu knowing everything, sitting inside. Sanatan, which way you are coming? Prabhu, actually I am coming that way. That way? It is hot sand. Hot sand, you can burn your... Let me see your leg. Let me see your leg. Oh, you develop bowel. How you go? You are suffering so much. Prabhu, I couldn't realize much by your mercy. Oh my God. Why you going that way? Why you don't like to go there? Come that way? Because that way actually Panda, those who are the sevak of Jagannath, they are moving that way. Somebody can touch me. It's great offense. This way, Rup Sanatan, everybody, they are showing humble attitude. Mahaprabhu always wanted to prove that if you like to come to me, if you like to attain the lotus feet, if you like to attain the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, first of all, you must learn from Rup Sanatan Raghunatha Goswami the humble attitude. Sanatan Goswami, when Mahaprabhu already reached there, Purushottam Dham, from Vrindavan, Sanatan Goswami, they find Rup Sanatan already gone to solve some financial problem in the, you know, village. Rup and Anupam, in the midway, at the bank of Ganga, Anupam, living body. When Mahaprabhu meeting Rup Goswami Path in Allahabad, speaking, I already meet Sanatan, this, that, this way, actually. Then after that, actually, Sanatan Goswami meet after. Anyway, Rupa Goswami Path, after that, actually, Sanatan Goswami coming to Purushottam Dham through Jarikhanda, from Vrindavan, Mahaprabhu came through Jarikhanda place while going to Vrindavan, also going through Jarikhanda. It is a shortcut place, at the same time forest. Jarikhanda is shortcut place, at the same time very nice place. It's forest. So Mahaprabhu going through that place. Sanatan also wanted to follow that same route. But Sanatan Goswami develops some problem, skin disease, all blood and urine actually coming out of. Somehow Sanatan reaching Purushottam Dham, Mahaprabhu got information, Mahaprabhu came to meet Sanatan, but Sanatan requesting Prabhu, I developed this kind of skin problem, I am fallen soul, don't touch me. But Prabhu forcefully approaching and taking him up and embracing. The Sanatan crying, I am developing some aparad, I should not live here. Because every day you can come and embrace me, and all my blood and, you know, and poison blood or can touch your body, transcendental body. So better I cannot see. Sanatan, don't speak like that. Whenever I embrace you, you think your body is useless. You think you are fallen soul. First day when I embrace you, I get the smell of chandan. Bad smell coming off your body? All your skin spoiled? But I get the first day when I embrace you, I get the smell of chandan. What you say? Sanatan Goswami took decision, this way I cannot live. Took decision to leave body under the wheel of Jagannath chariot. Well, Ratha Yatra coming. After looking Ratha Yatra, after looking, watching the Leela of Prabhu, I can throw my body under the wheel of Jagannath chariot. It's good. It's a solution. Otherwise, every day Prabhu can come and embrace me. I'm going to incur some aparad, growing some aparad. Mahaprabhu coming instantly. Sanatan! What Prabhu? Then in front of Haridas speaking, Haridas, you see, if I can put any treasure sampatti, money or gold to you, deposit, you can spend that money? No. Only deposit. If I keep some gold or money, anything, deposit with you, you have no right to spend. Because it is deposited by somebody. Someday you can... Is it right for Sanatan? Prabhu, what do you mean? Sanatan already give his life to me. Sanatan speaking, I am going to show my surrender unto your lotus feet. Surrender me? When you are 100% surrendered, that means that day you are sold like a beast. In Bhagavatam it is written, now you are like a sold beast. Like you can go to market and buy one beast, dog and horse or ass or, you know, cow, and putting in full sunshine, scorchy sunlight. But that animal cannot say, why you are putting me in sunlight? Eh? You yourself sitting in cold room, nice arch, eh? So costly room you are staying, but you are putting me in sunlight? I am feeling pain, cannot speak. In Bhagavatam it is written, Vikrito Pasor Yatha. In Bhagavatam it is written, Vikrito Pasor Yatha. Like a beast is sold in market, there's no privacy, no complaint, nothing. If you can get bhakti, all complaint finish. I know complaint is there, but all complaint finish. The day you can enjoy nectar, bhakti. So Sanatan, it is not good for you to take decision. What decision you mean, Prabhu? Don't try to hide. If I can get the lotus feet of Krishna by living body, then I can live every thousands of body I can live. If by living body, fancifully, if I can get the lotus feet of Krishna, what do you mean, Prabhu? Don't try to pass away. Then Sanatan started crying. You took decision to keep your life under the wheel of Jagannath. Is it good? You already sold yourself to me. Now you are, if you take you away and take independent decision, separate decision, then how it is possible? It is not possible. Then Mahaprabhu again coming and embracing Sanatan. Then Sanatan getting back the previous body. Again Mahaprabhu coming and forcefully embracing, kissing him. After then, Sanatan giving back, getting back the full previous body. Ah. Sanatan crying, Prabhu, that time I was having some humble attitude. Like that, Kushti Vipra also speaking that way. When Mahaprabhu giving back the full feature, nice body, Kushti Vipra, leprosy disease, that Brahman speaking. Why you, Prabhu, cure me? I was in nice condition. That time there was some humble attitude to me. Any insect, there is scat, you know, leprosy, you know, developing so blood and poison. Any insect coming out of this place, falling down, he put the insect. You stay here. What you can eat outside? There is some food. You take. Now, Prabhu, you rectify my body. I can develop. I cannot develop. So any kind of disease you are developing, any kind of insultment you are getting, any situation, you should remember, it is the mercy of Krishna. It is the mercy of Krishna. You should understand the Sanatan Siksha. I can touch something. I have to stop. From Jaipur, near Govinda temple, some Maharaj they are staying. They request me, give me order to come to explain Chaitanya Charitamrita there. I say, nowhere I am going. From Bakura, some devotees, they are crying, you come to explain Bhagavatam. I say, I am not going anywhere. I stop. How it is possible? Now point is that, Sanatan Siksha, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Varga saying, if you are not going to, if you are not going to get any clear idea, clear conception about Sanatan Siksha, then you cannot start your Hari Bhajan. You should remember Sanatan Goswami is a Sambandha Gyan Acharya. So big you will have to hear day by day about the activities of Sanatan Goswami. How I can explain within 2 hours? How different way Sanatan Goswami was trying by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to discover the places of Krishna Lila, Sthali, all scriptural evidence, Sriti, Sruti. How possible? How it was possible for Sanatan Goswami to discover Madan Mohan? Even Madan Mohan talking with him directly. At the bank of Govardhan, Sanatan Goswami sitting, Gopal coming, like Madhavendra Puripad, coming with a pot of milk, coming and giving to him, speaking, you drink this milk. You are a small boy, how you take trouble to come to me to give milk? No, everybody speaking, you are actually fasting. Fasting, how you know? How I can know everybody, those Bhajavasi coming here, they think you are fasting. So I bring, all your family member not coming, you are so small, why coming? Actually they are busy with making chapati, this, that. That's why I bring, okay, give the milk. Bring. Looking at him, so nice looking, drinking the milk and looking. After drinking, that boy is vanished. Vanished. And when Sanatan Goswami touching that milk with tongue, some current flowing, this milk? Oh, it must be Krishna. I couldn't arrest him. He's gone. Krishna. So Krishna. Oh my God. Krishna came from front of me to give milk. I couldn't realize. After that, Sanatan Goswami started doing all seva ordered by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sanatan Goswami used to stay later. So long story. I am speaking gist. Sanatan Goswami is staying in Nandagram, at Pavan Sarovar. Rupa Goswami is staying in Nandagram, in Terikadam. 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 Terikadam means there is one Kadamba Bhiksha. Mother Jasoda not like to allow small Gopal to go to take trouble. Then Gopal promised Mataji, Ma, I cannot go into deep forest. I can stay all around. How I can understand you as you actual mischievous activity you are doing all the time? How I can realize you are not going into deep forest? Ma, believe me, in Nandagram, around Nandagram, I can stay. How I can understand? Sometime I can play on flute, pooh, then you can understand I'm here. You can hear. Oh, then okay. Then Gopal playing and sometimes playing on fluids to give some signal to Mataji, Ma, Jasodama, I'm here, Ma, no problem. Huh? This way. Then Sanatan Goswami doing bhajan there in Terikadam, and Sanatan Goswami doing bhajan there in Pavan Sarovar, and Rupa Goswami doing bhajan there. One day Sanatan Goswami coming to meet Rupa Goswami path. Sanatan Goswami, Rupa Goswami was thinking that he is my guru. Actually guru. So many problem, contradictory point they think, those who are ignorant, they don't know. Who is the Gurudeva Sanatan? A foolish. Who is the Gurudeva Sanatan? Who is the Gurudeva Rupa Goswami? Who is the Gurudeva Jiva Goswami? Foolish number one. If you go deep into bhakti, you can realize yourself. Sanatan Goswami giving some bandana. Shikshaguru. Who is Shikshaguru? Vidya Vachaspati. Vidya Vachaspati, Shikha Guru, learning, or so many, or two, three, Shikha Guru. And Sanatan Goswami Pad, getting this kind of, you know. In Kirtan it is written this way. But Sanatan Goswami taking Dikha from whom? It is sometime it is written that Sanatan Goswami doing Bandana, Bandana there. Just Sanatan Goswami doing Bandana of Vidya Vachaspati Gurur me, Guru. Then from whom? Rupa Goswami Pad took Dikha. Rupa Goswami Pad took Dikha for Sanatan. From whom Jiva Goswami Pad took Dikha? From Rupa Goswami Pad. It is written in Kirtan, Gaura Parivar. Haha Pabhu Sanatana Gaura Parivar. It is written, Gaura Parivar. Follow this way. Now, Sanatana Goswami coming in front of Rupa Goswami Pad. Rupa Goswami Pad now thinking, today Guruji coming to me, so I like to offer Paramanna Bhoga so that I can give to Gurudev. But this kind of thinking, Sanatana Goswami, after that thinking, there's no arrangement, how I can make. In the meantime, a small girl coming, Lali, Brajavasi they're speaking, Lali, small Lali, coming. Baba, open the door. Who is that? Open the door, is nice, beautiful girl, so nice. What happens? Lali speaking, my mother sent some article to you to make bhoga, give bhoga. What? I mean, pure milk, sugar, rice. Oh, really? I wanted to make paramanna. Then collect everything, making paramanna. After making paramanna offering to Krishna, Radharani, Krishna, after that giving to Sanatan Goswami, take this paramanna, please. Sanatan taking this paramanna, touching leg, like current. What happens? Is paramanna? Who came? One small girl. No, that's Radharani. Why you take give trouble to Radharani? Why you give trouble? Radharani, never in future. Don't try to think that way. Actually, I was thinking that way. If I can offer some paramanna, I can feed you, give prasadam to you. Don't think that way. You are giving pain to Radharani, Vrishvahanu Nandini. Krishna himself always ready to serve the lotus feet of Radharani. And you are giving pain to that Radharani? Foolish? Don't do like that anymore. This way, how Sanatana Goswami discovered that Madan Gopal, Sanatana Goswami Pad going to Anchove's house, Chove's house in Mathura for begging. In a week, one time Sanatana Goswami going to beg some, you know, some atta, chun, going. Wheat, powder wheat. One in a week. That time Chove's house, the same Madan Gopal playing with the son of Chove, fighting. Yes. What's that? Madan Gopal. Krishna only eat love. Krishna want to take the taste of love, what you are going to grow inside your heart. Krishna is less interested about milk, chana, cheese, sweet ball, paramanna, Krishna is less interested. Krishna is very greedy to get the taste of your bhakti, what you are going to develop inside your heart. That much thing you should realize and change your life instant, because you cannot get time. You cannot get time. Time is going. Time is going. We are playing. Time is going. Chove's wife, Madan Gopal speaking, you are going to take bath, cooking so late, I am hungry. You have to give quickly. I am doing brass, morning time, it will take time going to, you know, field this, that. No, first of all, you have to cook. Without taking bath, you have to do. Then what Chobe's wife doing? With one stick, or nimba, wooden stick. Looking? And making khichdi with the opposite. Khichdi making. Gopal Bhai, okay, very nice, it's very tasty. But you are maintaining so rules and regulations, Gopal Bhai. I don't like to take. Duryodhan making so much arrangement. Actually, there's no appetite. I'm not hungry at present. Now going to Vidur house, in the 5 minutes, I'm very hungry. You are speaking lie? No, actually I'm not speaking lie. In front of devotee, I become very angry. Hungry. Duryodhan making so much arrangement with golden plate, this, that. Actually, I have no appetite. Next day, I can think after. When going to Vidur, there is no rice, nothing. I'm very hungry. Give something. This is Krishna. If you can realize who is Krishna, who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can start crying inside your room. Lock your room and start crying. Oh my God. I am Pasanda. I am Kamsa. And who is Krishna? How I can get kripa of Krishna? Try to become humble. To speak Harikatha with Acharan heavily. It is not that you are not humble. Prabhupada speaking heavily, maintaining Tinadapi. Not that you are speaking very nicely, sweetly. You want to pass away the main points. I want to prove in front of devotees I am nice Vaishnava. Actually, I have no time. I am developing fever. Today I cannot speak. What fever? If you have fever, you have to speak more Harikatha. Then fever can vanish. Same case with me. For 3 days fever, no problem. I feel happy, very nice body. No medicine can find solution. So anyway, I like to speak so much thing. So, Sanatan Sikha is very vital. If you have complete realization about Sanatan Sikha, then you can enter into Rupa Sikha. Sanatan Sikha is vital. Jive Sharupai Krishnandito Das, what is the point? How Jiva can get bhakti? I already discussed this point 3 months, 4 months ago. Also, I like to discuss in details how bhakti is possible for bonded soul. Bhakti is not a property of this material world. Bhakti is there. Follow. Not that. So must be very careful. Lakkhahira was successful to satisfy Gurudev Haridas Thakur by his cleanliness. His heart was clean. Maybe he was pros, harlot. But by now, enjoying Guru Kipa, Gurudev giving instruction, only we'll have to do Seva of this Tulsi and do 3 lakh Harinam. What is the magic spell that big Acharya coming to take darshan of Lakshahira? You never try to think about that. Your brain is so biased, you have no scope to think about this point. Blockheaded, your brain not working, you cannot understand how possible. Whereas Lakkhahira was, you know, pros, but still, by the mercy of Gurudev, all big Vaishnavas, Acharyas, they are coming to take kipa from Lakkhahira. You should think over and again. Sanatan Sikha, we should learn, we should understand, hear all day and night. Every day you will have to, today is Guru Purnima, I can touch this point. It will take another 10 minutes, I know, but still I will have to touch this point. Today is actually Guru Purnima. In Vrindavan, those Bhajavasis speaking Muriya Purnima. Muriya. Muriya, you know? What is Muriya? No. Actually, the Bhajavasis, when Sanatan Goswami is living body, they think our father, mother, or relative all gone. Bhajavasis crying like mad. Bare Baba chale gaya, chala gaya, Bada Baba mane Sanatan Goswami. Chote Baba means Rupa Goswami. Bare Baba duniya chorke chale gaye, matlab hamara, hum loot gaye. हम लूट गए आज, हमारा पिता माता भाई बंधु सब गया। ब्रजवासी दे ऑल शेप देयर हेड, दैट्स इट, दैट इज व्हाई दे से दे शेप देयर हेड, लाइक आफ्टर फादर गॉन यू हैव टू शेव योर हेड, दैट कॉल मुरिया पूर्णिमा। Another point, very secret, you must remember, this is called Guru Purnima. Why, Maharaj? My Guru Purnima, my Gurudev took birth there, that day. I already observed, yes, your bro, your Gurudev, his Gurudev, our Gurudev, or different. Because Vallabh Nityananda in different form coming in this material world as Gurudev, in front of you to deliver you at different time. Maybe your Gurudev coming that time, my Gurudev coming that, but all Tattva originally same. So your Gurudev Abhirbhav Tithi you must observe, my Gurudev Abhirbhav Tithi I must observe, your Gurudev Abhirbhav Tithi you must observe. No excuse, you have to observe. But what is Tithi today? But that is special Tithi today. Any Sadguru, today is a special day, any Sadguru from any four, any of these four authentic Sampradaya. Try to understand. Any Sadguru from any of this four authentic Sampradaya, any Sadguru there, as a whole, summation of Guru Tattva. Guru Tattva means Guru Tattva itself, undivisible attitude. You cannot divide Guru Tattva, is you cannot divide Guru Tattva, is akhanda Guru Tattva. Today we must worship akhanda Guru Tattva, all gurudev, follow all Sadguru. Today we have to worship all original Guru Tattva, follow. So today in Sanskrit we say Vyashti Guru and Samashti Guru. Samashti Guru, Vyashti Guru mean individual Gurudev. Pallavji Maharaj coming in individual form, maybe sometime coming in the form of Srila Bhakti Vaibhavpuri, you see Maharaj, to deliver you. But you are blind, you cannot see, my Gurudev lost. Well, lost Gurudev is there, if you have eyes you can see, follow. Your Gurudev took birth. This way all in different Abhirbhav Tithi we can worship. But today, we are worship as a whole Guru Tattva, Sadguru Tattva. You must worship this day today. You must save your head. You can start Chaturmasa. Chaturmasa you can start from Purnima also. You can start from Ekadashi also, Shayana Ekadashi. You can start from Dadasi also. There is no wrong. Approve. In Bhagavatam, Swayana Ekadashi, tu Uttana Ekadashi, it is written. But since Sanatan Goswami disappeared, our Guru Bhargava sometimes start from this day, save it, under the guidance of Brajavasi. No wrong in it. Brajavasi like to save their head. They think father, mother, everything gone. Bari Gosai Ghan mean, whenever those Bhajavasis they meet Sanatan Gosai, because Sanatan Roop, they never like to stay in one place. They like to travel in different villages. 84 crores, 84 crores. Whenever Sanatan Gosai, Baba, so long, hey, ab to bade dino mein aaya. After so long time you are coming to us. This way they are crying. They are sitting in front of Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami asking, where is your daughter? Baba, you are not coming for a long time. I give my daughter away in marriage. Where you give marriage? Husband, what doing? Asking, Brajavasi. People can think all material talkings. Sanatana Goswami, no, not material talkings. Brajavasis, I am taking information about Brajavasis. It is related with Krishna Bhakti. Follow. So what is Bhakti? What is not Bhakti? You must learn it first. Then you can get Bhakti. Follow what I say. So, Chaturmasya Vrata you have to do. In Chaturmasya Vrata, all Suti, Suti, Puran, they are praying in front of Kshirada Gosai Vishnu and praying Prabhu, 4 months, 4 months, Prabhu discovering sleeping Leela. And Suti Siti, they are praying unto his lotus feet. Jaya 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 yama jito doso vihito guna tamasi yadatmano samavaruda samastavaga. This look. Jaya jaya johi ajam. This way praying. I can explain this sloka someday. Today no time. So I'll have to stop. If you have any question, you can put in front of me. Today is Samasti Guru Puja. So Vairagya Yoga Bhakti Rasam Prajatnai Rapaya Yatmam Anuvishya Mandhyam Kipam Budhirya Paradukshya Dukhi Tvang Sanatanam Prabhum Asrayami Vancha Kalpadurusha Kipa Sindhu Bhavishya Patitanam Pavani Bhavishya Bhyo Namo. Any question?
I have heard from one of Gaudiya Vaishnava that to please our academically, to please our Guru Varga, we should learn Harinam Vyakarana. So we should learn how to speak Harinam Vyakarana, and this way our Guru Varga is pleased. And the Guru Varga is pleased, and then Lord Chaitanya is pleased. What do you say about?
Huh?
What is your opinion?
No, I cannot hear because my ear is blocked. With yes, I catch cold and fever. You come near to me so that I can hear properly. Or somebody can hear and...
He has heard that we should read or study Harinam Vyakaranam. So, because
yes.
Guru Varga is pleased. Right?
Guru Varga is pleased with that.
So Guru Varga is pleased and Mahaprabhu is pleased. So what would you say to this?
Not that. You must understand the inner meaning of your thing. I heard from my Guru Maharaj, whenever any devotee coming in front of Prabhupada, Prabhupada used to engage him in seva. Instant. Because Guru Vaishnav, they have their inner sight. They can look at you and understand. In what seva they can engage you, it is their duty. If you can find your own engagement yourself, that I can study Bhikaran. Many times it happens so. Somebody is speaking, Prabhupada, I can learn Bhikaran. No! Start Seva. And that Prabhupada engaged some special teacher for Bhakti Puri Goswami Mahaprabhu and some other devotees to give lesson about Naishudha. Naishudha, you know? What is the magic? It is openly we can say. You can say. But who is learning Bhakaran Harinam with what mood? That is different. Many times I spoke, somebody learning Vedanta to get respect. But one humble attitude with Maharaj, I don't know nothing about Vedanta. He passing lecture, first you will have to speak something. Now, they are erudite scholars, big scholar of Vedanta. Still you speak, you are doing bhajan. When you speaking, the scholar, they gone mad. How it is possible? You have done doctorate in Vedanta? No! Try to follow what I mean to say. So, if you want to enjoy full kripa of Guru Varga, first you try to follow him. It is right. It is openly there, that Harinam Vyakaran, at all if you are interested to learn Vyakaran, if you follow Harinam Vyakaran, it is full of Harinam, so anyway you are not going to waste your time. But can you show me one single, you know, bonded soul who is just qualified to keep proper track? Harinam Vyakaran, you can, not that Harinam because you can learn, you can ignore Guru Seva. Whereas vital point there in Bhagavatam. Try to understand my point. You have to do full Guru Seva. Then after that if you can get time, because Harinam Vyakaran is very nice. But first you will have to. do seva, guru seva. You can sit inside your room and learn. What use? Your background cannot give protection of this whole society. I like to see your personality so that you can give full protection to Gaudiya Sampradaya. Prabhupada is very clever. Prabhupada cannot allow this opportunity to everybody. You know, everybody going to waste time. Follow? They're going to... So how they can do Krishna bhajan? You have to do from today onward. Full, you have to shed, you know, sweat whole day and night. Serve. Anybody in front of you, you should think it is my Gurudev. Any ladies in front of you, it's my Gurudev, Radharani. You should think this way. Not one ladies, Radharani. If you can develop this kind of idea, come out successful. Otherwise, you try to learn Bekaran, try to learn Vedanta, no use, you cannot get. You cannot, anyway, you cannot ignore Guru Seva. Guru Seva first more. It is. Vancha Kalpata Roshya Kya Pasana Roshya. Vajram Pahana Bhavishya.
I just got one question. Recently, I was at my Guru Maharaj's temple in Bhubaneswara.
You've been there?
For Rath Yatra. And then they have Charanamrita of a morning. They have Radha Krishna Charanamrita, Gaunitai, Krishna Balaram, and my Guru Maharaj's Charanamrita.
Yes.
And I'm mixing all in one hand, then taking. And one brahmachari said, this is great offense.
yum. Very nice question. Very nice. Actually. Try to understand my point. Actually, try to understand. You should give honor to Gurudev Charanamrita. Gurudev Charanamrita. The brahmachari is speaking with one mood that you should not mix. Though originally all same. Shaksha Dharityana Samasya Sastri. But when you are going to take Gurudev Charanamrita, you take first. Second, you are going to take. If you mix, somebody can feel problem. Because originally it is all same. Radha, Govinda, Gauranga. Then why you are offering separately different bhoga? First of all. Though all same. Same plate you can arrange. Gurudev can take, Krishna can take, Mahaprabhu can take, all in hodgepodge, in one place. Is with separate honor. In Gauranga Lila you can find Nishingananda Brahmachari arranging one separate platform for Nishingadev. Follow. And for Gauranga separate plate. Gauranga Mahaprabhu separate plate. And for Nishingadev separate plate. Follow. And Prabhu coming and taking all. Nishingadev prasad. Hey, I don't take my prasad. Maishtadev, Nishingadev, you are taking prasad. You have your separate plate. Prabhu laughing. Nobody can see Prabhu coming from, you know, Purusottam Dham. Nobody can see, only he can see. Nishingananda shouting, hey, don't touch the plate of Nishingananda. You have separate plate. It's one kind of Baba. Don't try to break his Baba. Try to maintain your Baba. Okay, follow. Somebody speaking, there is big fighting in Vrindavan. Sometimes somebody is speaking, asking me some question, I am bound to answer. In Gurudev plate, no need of offering Tulsi, giving Tulsi. I mean, why? There is big fighting with Acharya. Gurudev plate, why need Tulsi? No need. Only Krishna's place Tulsi. Why? You should have this kind of feeling that whenever you are offering anything to Gurudev, Gurudev going to offer it first to Krishna, then going to take. With this darshan, all problems solved. They are fighting among themselves. Hey, we should not offer Tulsi to Gurudev. Why? You think Gurudev material? So, if you want to pay respect separately, nicely, they have their own position. Though original same, they have their own respective honorable position. Okay. Suppose somebody, great Vaishnava taking prasad. After that, one brahmachari is so foolish that Maharaj finishes his plate. Pata, leaf. That brahmachari taking prasadam there. He come with uchishta hand and take the plate of that Maharaj. That Maharaj become angry. Who told you to touch? Your Uchi says that first you will have to wash your hand. Come and touch this Uchishta of Gurudev. Because Gurudev Uchishta is not same with you. They are foolish, they are fighting. They don't know. You have to give honor. At all, if you like to serve Gurudev, then you will have to first wash your hand, take the plate and so. Or if you like to take some Uchishta. If you Uchishta hand, with Uchishta, if you come and take Uchishta, still you are doing aparat. Because you are not giving honor. Follow?
But in this case, putting Charanamrita of Guru and Krishna and taking, is that an offense?
No, first of all you can take Gurudev. But then Gauranga, okay. Anyway, here some soft heart you are speaking this way. Originally everything is same. But still, in if you take Charanamrita, same place going. So, stool and urine, they are inside your body. So if you say, what problem if I touch urine? And so Maharaj is showing excesses. And urine in stool is there inside your body. Everybody knowing. But still, externally, you will have to maintain some rules and regulations. If you touch urine and stool, some person who is coming from crematory and ground, or some Mataji sick, if you, then how you can do bhajan? Maybe you will have to maintain. The more you can maintain purity, the more you can maintain your bhajan. If you are less interested about maintaining your purity, you cannot expect bhajan to come in your life. Purity is a must. Nishtha hoite upajaya premet tarango. Nishtha.